it seems like our bear population is mostly south of Interstate 44. We have proposed some research to try to come up with a population estimate. We really don't know how many bears we have in the state. There's been some estimates of around 300 animals, but these are just guesses. We do know that we have a growing population, and we have reproduction, so we're seeing cubs, we're getting reports of bears. They only breed every other year, and they will only have 1 to 3 cubs. As a result, you just don't have explosive populations when you're dealing with black bears. With that in mind, I think we can predict a slow growth of our bear population. Bears, like a lot of our big game species, were just exploited early on. Settlers drastically changed the landscape. They just were hunted and there were no regulations. So as a result, populations just disappeared. Now, how did they come back? Well, we do know that Arkansas released about 254 bears in 1959 through the middle 60s. And it's likely that some of these animals dispersed into Missouri. And those bears probably formed the basis of our population. And so, you know, since 1960, over this 50-year period, we've slowly cultivated a bear population. You know, I'm really excited about having bears recolonizing the state. To me, bears are a symbol of the wilderness, and it tells us that we have a piece of Missouri that is still wild enough and pristine enough to support a population of bears. There's not a lot of states that can say that. So we've done something right here. You know, bears are on the radar screen now, so when we make management decisions, we're going to take bears into account. And I think the safest place for an animal to be is a situation in which we know what the population is so we can manage them intelligently. We don't want to have too many bears so that the public becomes intolerant to the species. So I think if we can regulate the species in a way that it balances with habitat and social capacities, we're going to have bears for a long time.